When thin extrudes were first introduced back in January, it was only capable of extruding closed profiles. In the April update, it has finally been made available for open profiles as well. Just a quick recap of what thin extrudes are before we begin. The basic premise is this. Instead of creating a set of four lines that defines the boundaries of a wall, we can simply sketch a single line, and the extrude command automatically adds the thickness. Suppose that we want to create a series of heat fins on the back of this housing. The traditional way would be to sketch a rectangle, extrude the profile, and pattern it. With thin extrudes, we just need to sketch a single open line. In the extrude command, select the thin extrude option and select the open sketch line as a profile. Adjust the wall height and wall thickness. We can also adjust the wall location to be on either side of the line by choosing side 1 or side 2. Or we can make it symmetrical about the line by choosing center. This starting fin can then be patterned. One crucial point about thin extrudes is that the thickness is added in a direction that is perpendicular to the profile or along the length of the profile. For example, if the sketch line for the fin is at an angle, we would have a problem of the end faces not matching up with the base. To emphasize again, the wall thickness extends in a direction perpendicular to the sketch line at all points. This is applicable to arcs and splines as well. When it comes to creating intricate patterns consisting of thin walls, consider using thin extrudes. This can save you the time needed to create offset sketch entities. More importantly, these sketch lines will be a lot easier to dimension and control. I have an example of a fish bait design here. We have a series of thin plates that has been shaped into a fish-like body. Before the introduction of thin extrudes, we could have done this using a traditional closed sketch. Extrude and pattern. Or we could also have extruded an open sketch line into a surface and thicken. The thin extrude feature has essentially combined both the surface extrude and thicken steps into one. With thin extrudes, we simply need to sketch a single line. After the sketch is done, we can immediately begin the extrude command. The plate width and thickness can be controlled within the extrude command. Pattern a plate using a rectangular pattern. Finally, use a loft with intersect as the operation. We can also consider using thin extrudes for creating sheet metal-like bodies. This removes the need for creating offset entities. When we add thickness in the extrude command, the command would ensure even thickness all along the length of the profile. This means that opposing fillets would automatically be taken care of. We actually have an existing feature that is similar to the thin extrude, and that is a web command. So how do these two commands compare? We will use this round container as an example. Suppose that we need to create a series of ribs. I have prepared a sketch line in the middle, using the top face as the sketch plane. Let's test out the web command first. Go to Create, Web. Select the sketch line as a curve. We want the rib to be symmetrical about the sketch line, so set the thickness option as symmetric. For that, choose to next. With this option, the command would automatically look for the bottom of the container to terminate against. Let's adjust the thickness. you can see that no matter how far you adjust the thickness, it would always terminate up against a cylindrical face. Keep this in mind when we use a thin extrude later. If we pattern this feature, all subsequent features would respect the cylindrical face. Let's repeat using thin extrude. For extent type, choose tool object and select the bottom face. Set wall location as center. Let's set the operation to new body for the moment and try to exaggerate the thickness. You can see that the extrude does not terminate nicely up against the cylinder. Let's set the operation to join and go back to a normal thickness. The limitation of the thin extrude becomes obvious when we attempt to pattern this. The patterned features exceed the cylindrical face, even when we use adjust as a compute option. This example is actually slightly unfair to the thin feature, as this situation is what a web command was designed for. Web features tend to excel when we need to build thin walls in the confines of existing walls. When it comes to building open thin walls like heat fins, it would be better to go with thin extrudes. To a certain extent, the web command can also be used to build heat fins by adjusting the depth options, but this can be cumbersome and non-intuitive. The major advantage that the thin extrude has over the web command is that it has access to all the options of a typical extrude. There is a variety of start and end conditions available. Usually, it can be used to cut, while the web command can only add material.